Have you ever woken up one day and wondered to yourself, what is a ripple in space-time? And how did its discovery unlock a completely new way for us to understand our universe? Well, you're in luck. Here at Vanderbilt, we've got some of the world's top experts leading the way in this field. So buckle up and let's get gravitational. Let's start back in the year 1915, a time when a home would have cost you about $2,500 and electricity had been in that home for only 30 years. It was then that Einstein published his general theory of relativity. This theory proposed that the universe itself was not just made up of separate dimensions of space and time, but rather four-dimensional space-time. If matter makes a dimple in the fabric of space-time, then when matter moves around, the dimple must move too. It's those ripples in space-time from moving matter that we call gravitational waves. And they don't just travel through the universe, they are the universe, carrying the message of matter in motion to us and beyond. This concept would shake the world of physics, but would remain just a theory for about a century. So now let's fast forward to the 21st century.
Thanks to innovations in technology, I was part of a team that first detected gravitational waves in the not so distant past of 2015. It was surreal to be one of the first humans listening to gravitational waves that has been emitted from billion light years away and traveled all this far in the universe to communicate its story to us. The discovery showed that Einstein's theory of relativity was absolutely far ahead of its time.
This has opened up a sixth sense, no, not that sixth sense, for scientists to better understand the fabric of space-time that we are all a part of.
We are all matter. When you move your hand, you're sending out gravitational waves that ripple through the fabric of space-time. Now, the waves we make are much too small to ever detect, but I study black holes that are so mind-bendingly massive that they bend space-time. You could say that they're defying gravity, but up until gravitational waves were detected, we had no idea black holes could collide. We had only a few senses to work with. Like light.
Astronomers like me use telescopes to study growing supermassive black holes, which are messy eaters like the Cookie Monster. So as they swallow gas, more goes out than goes in, and this gas shines and gives me something to look at. Light. We used to just see the universe. Now, with gravitational waves, we can hear it too. This allows us to chart the warped side of the universe by detecting objects we never could before. And when we combine this with other data, it's like watching the most immersive movie of the cosmos.
We're not just looking out into space anymore. Now we're also listening. So why as scientists are we so excited?
We're not just scientists. We're dreamers turned investigators pursuing the biggest questions of our time and space.
Gravitational waves is the way we can understand what happened at the time when the universe was born. Without exploring bold ideas and testing limits, we wouldn't have the understanding of the world around us today.
So my friends, next time you ask yourselves about gravitational waves, just know, the universe is speaking, and we can finally tune in.